Good morning, Nick here from Opportunity Private Capital. It gives me great pleasure today to invite one of our investors, Tracy, into the chair for our investor Snapchat. Morning, Tracy, how are you?
Morning, Nick, good,
good to see you, Trace.
And you, as always.
Thank you. So, Trace, we'll go straight into it. You're a successful businesswoman.
Yep. I hope successful, but I think
Well, externally, yes.
Yeah, okay.
So, and you strike me as very particular about how you structure your life and how you presumably structure your investments as well.
Yeah.
So thank you for being here. I look forward to those insights.
Pleasure.
What's your general view of the economy and available investments out there?
So within my little sphere of things that are immediately in front of me, I choose what I perceive to be the best option for me.
Okay.
So I look at the little bubbles of things that I do know about.
Right.
And research those, and within those I make my choices. They're never economy based. They're based on listening to people that I trust.
Okay, so do you chat, obviously then you chat to friends and colleagues,
yeah,
about investments and,
yeah,
and business in general.
Yeah.
So what are they investing in at the moment?
Well, quite a lot of people I know investing with you.
Sure, okay.
There's a lot of talk about offshore, and obviously I've got a financial guy and they talk about offshore. I'm very cautious, so I'm very cautious as to what I do and where I put my money.
Yeah. You strike me as someone who wants to understand the investment that you're putting your money into. Do you have any opinions on the difference between saving and investing itself?
Yeah, and I do believe in having saving. I always like to know that there's a little amount available for the whatever may come up.
Your emergency fund.
My emergency fund, which
right,
obviously we know is low interest and just sort of sits. It's like an emergency fund.
Yeah.
And then investing in a very, well, for me, moderate return. Well, it has always been a moderate return,
okay,
which is safe,
right,
until you came along. So as I say, when I first went in, I dipped my toe in very small because I can't afford to lose money.
Yeah.
I was cautious about what I did.
Trace, do you enjoy the fact that we offer fixed per annum returns, or do you prefer the volatility of investments
where you can get
higher returns if it goes really well, and maybe then you'd lose on the downside if things go badly? What's your opinion on that?
No, I very much like a fixed return because it's mapped out for me. I mean, I had some money and they moved it unbeknown to me. Well, maybe I said yes and wasn't listening.
No names mentioned, of course.
What? No. And they put it into high volatility and the returns were fantastic. So
okay,
I saw the returns.
Right.
But the minute I saw where it was written somewhere you're in a high risk sort of category.
Right.
I phoned them and said, get it. Even though I'd made good money and I saw it on paper, I said, get it right out of there because I don't enjoy that.
You've got a low appetite for risk, fair
yeah,
enough. You're pretty conservative.
Yeah.
Across the board, I'd say.
Yeah.
Given that, do you like the fact that you can go to our investor portal and look at your investments updated, etc., or do you just let them be
I did let them be. And then I obviously get my little summary every couple of months. I don't even know how often it is. And I look at it, but I pretty much know what it is. And to the T almost, it is that. You know, I know mentally where I think I'm at, and I'm at exactly that when I see it.
Right.
But it has been nice now with a new portal because I recently put in some more money. So it was quite nice to go onto it and see, bam, up it came. So that was nice. But would I look at it? Most probably not.
Okay. So it's just a subliminal sense of comfort,
yeah,
that something's there if you
and
need
if
to.
And if I want to look at it, I can.
Do you know how many investment cycles you've been through with this?
Nick, I think my first one was in the beginning of 2018.
Yeah, I think you could be right.
So
I'll have to check, but I think you're
18,
right.
19. Yeah, I think I'm going to my 18. Yeah, I think I'm going to my fourth cycle with you now.
Yeah. Okay.
And each time I've upped the ante a little.
Yes, I think you have.
Yeah.
Can you summarize the positive and negative aspects of investing with us?
I'll start on the short one, the negatives. I mean, Nick, honestly, I can say there has not been, and I mean it honestly, I can't say that I can fault you on anything. The communication is brilliant.
Okay.
There was one thing that didn't go according to your plan, and that was when there was a holdup in the Masters Court due to COVID. So they said you won't get paid this week, you'll get paid next week. You're informed, and you're informed 2 days later that you're acknowledged and you're kept in the loop. And then you're told the money's going to be released tomorrow, and it's released tomorrow. And the positives are, I suppose, just that you do what you say you're going to do. And
oh, thanks.
What you promised you deliver.
Right.
And it's just about communicating with someone.
So that sense of comfort means is a driver for you. Does it give you added comfort for your future investments with us that we were able to perform and give you your returns even during that pandemic period?
Massive. I did. I sort of with dread looked at a lot of my investments sort of during that time, just thinking like, what's happening? And it's nice to know that you guys survived COVID. So I cannot give you a black point. I literally cannot.
Thank you. Trace, thank you for your time.
Absolute pleasure.
Lovely to see you and talk to you again. And I look forward to seeing you again.
Definitely.